Lovel, he stood by his castle door. He was a-combing his milk-white steed, and along come Lady Nancy Bell, a-wishing her lover good speed. She's a-wishing her lover good speed. Oh, where are you going, Lord Lovel, she said. Oh, where are you going, said she. I'm going, dear Lady Nancy Bell, strange countries far to see. Strange countries far to see. When will you be back, said she, in a year or two or three at the most, I'll return to my Lady Nancy, I'll return to my Lady Nancy. He hadn't been gone but a year at the most, strange countries far to see. When languishing thoughts come deep in his mind, Lady Nancy he would see, Lady Nancy he would see. So he mounted up to his milk-white steed, and he rode to London's fair town. He heard St. Barney's bells ring out, and people was a-mourning around. People was a-mourning around. Is anyone dead, Lord Lovel, he said. Is anyone dead, said he. Some called her Lady Nancy Bell, some called her Lady Nancy, some call her Lady Nancy. He had the grave open forthwith, the pall a-falling down, and then he kissed her cold, cold lips, while tears come a-trickling down, down, down. Tears come a-trickling down. Now they buried her in the old churchyard, Lord Lovel lay buried beside her, and out of her bosom there grew a red rose, out of Lord Lovel's a briar, out of Lord Lovel's a briar. They growed and they growed to the old churchyard, they couldn't grow any higher, and there they tied in a true love's knot, the rose around the briar.